Hello guys, hope you're doing great. I'm your instructor Ajay Naik, and this is a special video which I have made just to share my experiences when I was learning UI5 initially. And I think I was learning two things parallelly. I was learning UI5 and I was also learning JavaScript libraries called D3 and all the analytics stuff. So it was very difficult for me certain times, and there are some things which when I look back and I say, okay, I could have done it better. So I will be sharing some of the experiences and some of the things which I have faced and how to really overcome those challenges as quickly as possible. So the main idea is, when you are learning these skills online on self-paced, the idea is that you are already in a job, and you might not get time to really watch a lot of content. So what I will tell you to do is always try to go through the coding assignments, or maybe the code snippet which I have given you. You may not have 7 hours continuously. If the course is of 7 hours or 8 hours, like our UI5 Advanced Professional, we have covered, I think, almost all the things in detail, so it's a very long course. One doesn't take only 7 hours. It can happen that you take around 14 hours or 20 hours. Just watch all the videos. So you are watching one video, you are going back and again watching it, and then you have other things to do as well. You have your job, a lot of things in life goes on, and it is not easy to continuously give time to a course, and you are learning those things the first time. So when you practice those in your own browser or your own computer, then a lot of things will not happen as it happens with me. So those things are one thing to consider, that you will always take more time than me or someone else when they are teaching, because these people have already faced those issues. Small semicolon and commas can really take entire 2 hours or 3 hours if you cannot see them in the program. So be a little patient. So that's one thing which I will say. And never really think that, okay, something is going to be very easy, because maybe for us, we don't see that thing happening, because we might have faced some issues initially. Most of the time, spelling mistakes are a common problem when you're writing something and then suddenly some variable or like some function is misspelled, then the error will be coming, and it's a big program. It's very easy to miss those kind of things. So be a little patient, and it takes time to really go to a level of understanding where you have some kind of mastery. You can work on enterprise stuffs, or you can work on projects which requires little expertise. And when you are in a project, there will be always this time constraint. You have to deliver things fast. They will not be waiting for you to learn. So those are the times when you will, if you're already in a project, you are working on a project and your project requires expertise which you are learning, then I think it will be very crucial to complete those courses as soon as possible. And always do the practice. There are a lot of assignments and coding exercises which has been given. All the codes has been given to you in GitHub and Cloud9. So you can look at those codes and you see all the codes. But the main idea of doing the code from your own side is crucial here, because when you're doing it from your own side, even if you're copying some part of the code which is existing and just replicating those, you get an understanding about what are the bigger chunks in my whole program which are coming together, just making the entire thing work. So that is important here. You should be having a broad picture, but also a detailed level picture of what is happening in this part and the next part. And this is critical to understand, and that's how actually I learned as well. And one more thing which when I'm talking about UI5, is I face a lot of issues when I was working with library, because the API reference is like very overwhelming. Because for example, you take example of this list, sap.m.list, and then when you are going to use the sap.m.list, then there are so many functions which could be possible, and you may not know how to use those things or what the function does. So all this thing will come over time. To start with, you only need to know a couple of the functions which is like very frequently used. some of the very commonly used functions. So what we have tried to do is we have tried to cover all those functions within the course itself. And over the time, when you are going back to API reference again, you're looking into other functions, and everything will fall into place, and you will be much more confident when you are giving time on those components, working on those components. You may have to spend a lot of time in the console. If you're spending a lot of time in console, experimenting with elements, experimenting with your project, what can be done here, what will happen if I use some other function, you're experimenting with them, then you will also get a better understanding, and it will stick in your brain. And that's important. You need to also use the console as much as possible. And one thing which I really face challenge is in the visualization, because as you might have seen that the API reference are changing very rapidly, and after 1.34 version, the way of using visualization was completely changed. And that's something which is always happening. The libraries are always updated. You need to keep track with what is happening in UI5 world. And when I was working there, I was always experimenting before using any kind of visualization. I was confused about flattened data set, and I was always like, hidden trial method was my way of doing it when I first used it. And still, even if the things was working, I was pretty confused why it was working. So after a lot of trial and error, I got to understanding. I got to know exactly how things click together. So it will definitely be a big learning curve on those visualization things. And there are some advanced concepts which one need to understand before really taking on to bigger challenges. For example, when I was working on one of the customer asked me, how can we have one input field in my list when I put my mouse cursor over that input list button, then it was actually list input. So when I put my mouse cursor inside that input list, then the color of that input should change. So this kind of custom requirements will be given to you by user. There will be a lot of different business processes you might be working on. Your customers might be from many different countries, because it's like SAP solution. So you can expect customer from a lot of different regions. So they are very clear on what they are doing, their business process. And we have to kind of be flexible in our software to make or give them exactly what they need. So that should be our goal, to make them happy with our solution. And for that, you need to do a lot of customization. You might be using jQuery UI to give some fancy coloring, some jazzy controls, and the result will be like they will be happy at the end of the day if you do something. But the problem is it will be very difficult to maintain. Your solution will be very difficult to support or maintain. So you need to also have understanding of how can I build this feature inside the UI5 itself, so the people who are supporting it, they are able to do it on a very easy way. Or what is the ideal way of building those fancy things or jazzy things? So those are some of the things which we covered in the advanced concept. How can you create your own library components? And these are very critical when you really are a professional. Then I think JavaScript is very easy to learn compared to other languages, and now a lot of people are learning JavaScript. Becoming a professional guy who is expert in JavaScript is difficult, because there are a lot of confusing concepts. So we created this course of Advanced UI5 Professional, which is for people who want to really differentiate themselves from all the other guys who only know UI5. And these people can also go inside UI5 library, hack these libraries, and create their own custom components, do much fancier things like filtering, sorting in tables, and use maps. So these are very common requirements which are coming, and customers are actually paying a lot of money to developers or external contractor consultant to be able to extend those library features in UI5. And keeping that in mind, we thought that how can we create a course which is like easy, because we don't want to really complicate professional development. If you take this course, you will be able to work in UI5, that is for sure. But we also want to give an edge to our students who want to get something more done. And we thought of creating this advanced professional course. So you can also check out the advanced professional course. It's a real deal. Apart from that, I think we also created this gateway course, because many times what we are seeing, what we have seen in marketplace, that a customer requires only one guy who knows end-to-end. And we said, okay, if you can deliver this solution end-to-end, then I think we will go for you as a contractor, or we'll be paying you more money, or it will be very nice, this kind of terms you might have heard. So the value of an end-to-end consultant is very high in the marketplace. For this enterprise development, if one guy is just responsible for the entire delivery of one application, then the communication overhead is also quite less, and then people are very happy. So therefore, keeping that in mind, we thought that how can we also give you the knowledge of how to work with backend, which is like creating your own services. Little ABAP coding is required. Sometimes the ABAP coding is not that complicated itself. You have to get data, you have to put data. So this is like the standard things which is expected. Not much complicated things really happens here. Based on the functional requirement, like if you're working in plan maintenance module, or you're working in SD or MM, it can change, the complexity can change. But generally, the backend logics are just dealing with your databases. You are getting the variables from your URL parameters, and accordingly, those services will perform your activity. So these are some of the things which we have already created courses on NetWeaver Gateway. And what we will do in future is, we will be also creating a lot of assignments. If you are having any questions, then we will be replying through these videos, because a lot of time we don't have time to really shoot and go for the professional level of shooting as we did in our courses. We cannot compromise on quality, but we also want to make sure that when you are coming to our platform, UI5CN.com, then you get the best experience. You get the things for which you signed up. So that's our goal mainly. So if you have any more questions, or you're facing some issues related to your project, technical, non-technical, any advice on the career choices in UI5 or based on JavaScript world or in the enterprise itself like SAP, we will be happy to help you. We don't charge for consulting to our students. It will be like a free genuine advice from us, from our own experiences. We have like a 5-person team here, and most of them are SAP consultant with a lot of experiences, 17 to 15 year experiences, and we will be very happy if we could help you in any ways. So connect with me at ajay@ui5cn.com if you have any queries, or connect with our CEO at nuno@ui5cn.com, and have a great time learning technology. I will see you again. My name is Ajay Naik, CTO and co-founder of UI5cn. Learn simple.